Right, Stevie, thanks for joining us. You'll be a happy man. 3 points always makes you a wee bit happier, and it was particularly pleasing the manner of it on Saturday as well, I'm guessing.
Yeah, we knew, obviously, Air United had attacking threats. But the pleasing thing for ourselves was to get that home victory. We're on a wee run at the moment, undefeated in the last four, but to go a goal behind as well, it was testing the character of the team. So, as I say, it was a good way to end the first quarter and to get the 3 points and send everybody home happy.
And I guess we can't talk about the game on Saturday without mentioning Lee Ashcroft's goal, and particularly after scoring our own goal as well, which was unlucky. There wasn't much you could do about it, but to come back and hit a ball like that was pretty impressive.
Listen, I don't know if he'll ever score a goal like that in his career again, but to be fair to Lee, you know, and I'll probably take a bit of stick for saying this on camera, in the lead up to training last week, from training to the game, he actually joined in a couple of finishing exercises, and you know, he was hitting the back of the net, so not that I foreseen that he was going to get a goal like that to get us back into the game, but delighted for him. I said at the time, the equaliser, and it gave the boys a belief to then kick on, and you know, Andy Ryan put his goal away expertly as well, and albeit on his right foot, but you know, it was pleasing on the day to come away with the 3 points, and Ashley's goal was very fitting as well.
In fact, all three goals that we scored on Saturday were actually, the first goal was really well worked, and as you said, Andy Ryan's finish for the third was fantastic as well.
Yeah, I think Ryan down, then he plays the ball into Nizzy, and it's a great wee flick, but the timing of the run as well, with the combinations between Nizzy and Kilty, and you know, he didn't panic, he walked round the keeper, and you know, we were probably a little bit more worried on the bench, but he stuck it away. But Andy Ryans, you know, that Ryan Dow again had an influence. He won the ball high up the park for us. Greg Kilty gets onto it and slid it down inside the centre backs, like we had asked him to do on the training pitch. So it was pleasing. And Andy Ryan, you know, he's now starting to ask us questions. He's scored a couple of goals coming off the bench, and you know, he's not far away from pushing himself into starting 11.
On paper, you looked at these two fixtures, Ayr United on Saturday and Dundee United this Saturday, top two in the league. We beat Ayr, who are second on Saturday, and we're playing Dundee United, who are still top, but they got a bit of a doubt at the weekend against Queen of the South, so it's all to play for in this league, and I know it's a sort of cliche with the Championship, but you know, anyone can beat anyone on their day.
No, listen, you've just said it, it's very tight, and I think sometimes we sound like stuck records managers that come up against one another, but there's very few matches where, you know, you get an absolute doing. Albeit, I know Dundee United have lost before goals to Queen of the South, but having watched the game back, Dundee United had chances in the game as well, so it's a bit of a false result in terms of, you know, the four-goal margin. But, as you say, the last home game, they won 6-0 against Morton, so we have to go up there with a bit of confidence in ourselves with the run that we're on, but also be wary of what the backlash might be as well.
The only game, I think, you know, you were probably really disappointed with this season was the Dundee United game at home. So it's a chance to make amends, and Tannadice is a place, you know, we went there last season and won, so it should hold no fears for us.
No, you're right. The first half, more so than any game this season in the league, was the Dundee United game that we felt we weren't at the races. Collectively, we all agreed on it. It's not as if it was just the management team. The players know that. I'm not saying let ourselves down, but you know, we just weren't at the races for whatever reason. It came on the back of the Celtic game. Did we lose our focus? You know, in hindsight, looking back, it's easy. But what I will say is we've regrouped, we've developed as the quarter went on. And it's a game that we've now given ourselves a chance of going into with a bit of confidence to go up there and make sure we try and get a result.
You mentioned there's four games unbeaten, and you know, a run like that, as was shown last season, can really propel you up the table. So another few wins, and all of a season the table looks completely different.
Yeah, well, it's not just the Dundee United game, it's a big week. You've got Arbroath on Tuesday night and then Queen of South on Saturday. So it's a big week early in the season. The games are going to come thick and fast for everybody in the league. And one that we're looking forward to the challenges.
In terms of injuries, how are we looking ahead of the weekend?
Yeah, obviously you had the two head knocks with Ryan Dow and Paul Payton, but both have trained. And that's what it takes to win matches. You know, for as much as we want to try and encourage boys to play football and nice, attractive stuff to win games of football, it's important that we compete in the physical side, but everybody's, you know, raring to go again. Tom Lang will hopefully train towards the end of the week, but the game will obviously come too soon. Joe Thompson will be involved in the reserve game against Celtic, he'll get 45 minutes, but he's still, you know, a good bit away from looking at first team action.
And finally, just a quick word about the Scottish Cup draw, which happened at the weekend. We are Stranraer away from home. It's not the most glamorous of places to go, but if we want to progress in the Cup, these are the teams that we should be taking care of at this stage of the tournament.
Yeah, you know, the Scottish Cup is what it is, and it's something that was disappointed when, you know, I first got the job last year. The game came at us very quickly in my management reign here. But, you know, Stranraer away, if you want to progress in the tournament, you have to go to places like this. It'll be a tough fixture. It's not an easy place to go. And as I say, we'll do our homework. But we've got a big week coming up with the league games at the moment, and we'll fully focus on that first.